एवरीवन, ओके। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द सेशन दैट ओके द फर्स्ट ओके द फर्स्ट एमसीक्यू दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज ओके। सो कमेंट ऑन द टाइप ऑफ स्टोन, कमेंट ऑन द टाइप ऑफ स्टोन बेस्ड अपॉन एक्सरे क्रिस्टलोग्राफी, कमेंट ऑन द टाइप ऑफ स्टोन, कमेंट ऑन द टाइप ऑफ स्टोन बेस्ड अपॉन एक्सरे क्रिस्टलोग्राफी। यस सो so any answer from the audience? Yes, can you see this typical appearance? Can you see the typical appearance that you can notice here? Yes, so these are prismatic, na? Prismatic, this is what is prismatic, or you can say needle shape, prismatic or needle shape. Yes, and prismatic or needle shape stones, yes, they belong to, this is not calcium oxalate, this is not calcium oxalate, this is prismatic or needle shape. So sharp needle shape, this is Guntas beta, this is a brucite stone, this is what is a brucite stone. Not visible, I mean not visible to all. Just see, just give me a chance. Audio, video clear? Is audio video clear to everyone? Okay. Oh, chalo. Done. I hope it's clear. Okay. So this is comment on the type of stone on X-ray crystallography. This is a classical needle of prismatic shape stone, and this is what is a brucite stone. Let us talk something about the stone. By this we can quickly revise the concept of stone. Okay, quickly let us write 5-6 important points. So based upon this, let us discuss the variety of stones and their shapes. If you talk about stones and their shapes, stones and their shapes, yes, so the first we have is what? The first we have is calcium oxalate, calcium oxalate, yes, monohydrate and dihydrate. Come on, tell me, monohydrate, what is the shape of monohydrate, calcium oxalate monohydrate, what is the shape? The shape is what? The shape is dumbbell shape, the shape is dumbbell shape. Yes, dihydrate, yes, it's envelope shape, it's nothing but a dumbbell with one more bond, so it becomes envelope. And this is what is what? A classical dumbbell shape. Then phosphate, simple phosphate stone, simple phosphate stones, yes, coffin lid, yes, or coffin lid. Now A staghorn. What is a staghorn calculus? What is a staghorn calculus? Staghorn calculus. This is a struvite. Staghorn is a struvite occupying. What is the minimum criteria for a staghorn calculus? For a, you know, all staghorns are struvites, but all struvites are not staghorns. So what is the criteria? So staghorn calculus is a struvite occupying at least 20% of the pelvic caliceal system. Occupying at least 20% of pelvic caliceal system. This is what. Okay, this is staghorn calculus. Next is, let us talk about few more. Come on, tell me, cysteine stone. It is hexagonal. Yes or no? Then Bruchite stone. It's a needle shaped. Or you can say prismatic. Yes. Again. Uric acid stone. What they are? Yes. Uric acid stones. Yes. They are amorphous shards. When you talk about amorphous shards, this is like a plate. So they are plate-like. Yes or no? So these are the classical stones and their images. Again, those who have joined late, we have actually started with this quiz, and the stone, the question which I have asked was, what kind of stone is this? The shape that you are getting to see on X-ray crystallography. On X-ray crystallography, what it is representing? This is a classical Bruchite stone. Yes, let us move forward and let us go to the next question. Yes. Just wait. Okay, let us revise this. Identify the instrument shown and the procedure and the indication. Come on. Identify the instrument and the procedure and the indication for this. Come on. Identify the instrument, procedure and the indication. Come on. Someone is saying this is TUIP. I hope. If you are saying this is TUIP, what is TUIP, students? Transurethral incision of prostate. Yes or no? Incision of prostate. Someone is saying yes, but see, this is absolutely wrong, because this is not a transurethral incision of prostate. In that case, the image would have been like this. Yes or no? The image would have been like this. With a Collings knife, you do a dissection. So this is done with a Collings knife. So you start just above the verumentonum and go up to 9 o'clock and 5 o'clock, 9 o'clock and 3 o'clock position. Yeah. This is not. Anyone else? You can attempt it. At least you can answer. Yes. Try to answer it. Identify the instrument and the procedure. Yes. Have you heard of this Eurolift? Eurolift, or this is also known as prosthetic lift. Okay. Has anyone heard of this concept of Eurolift or prosthetic lift? This is what is again very, 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 very important. What is the concept of Eurolift or prosthetic lift? And then we will try to understand this thing. Yes, try to see this. So the procedure which is shown here, yes, is a Eurolift or a prosthetic lift. Yes or no? Yes. You can say pull. PUL is okay. Now try to understand what is the concept of this Eurolift that I have shown to you. Eurolift is a procedure where you go for trans prosthetic placement of placement of spring loaded sutures. Spring loaded sutures. So transprostatic placement of spring loaded suture. Now try to understand the basic concept of TURP, BPH, and then you will understand everything. The prostatic capsule doesn't allow the benign prostatic hyperplasia mass to expand out, and ultimately what will happen? Ultimately, this prostatic urethra is what? Compressed. This prostatic urethra is compressed. Yes or no? Because of the growth. So what we do in this procedure, which is known as urolift, what we do, we go inside via urethra, and at the level of prostate, you place the spring loaded sutures. Now what will happen when you release these spring loaded sutures? When you release the spring loaded suture, students try to understand what will happen. It will pull. Can you see? The spring will contract and it will pull the what? Prostatic urethra. So what is this doing? Yes, if you see, when you place a spring loaded suture across the prostate, what will happen? The prostatic urethra will ultimately what? Yes, will ultimately open up. The prostatic urethra will ultimately open up. So this is mechanical dilatation of the prostatic urethra. And how this happens? Yes, with the help of urolift or prostatic urethral lift, PUL. This is also known as prostatic urethral lift. Urethral lift, also known as PUL procedure. I hope this is clear. So now we go to the next. We go to the next flashcard. Yes, let us see this. Now, come on, answer this. Identify the vascular pathology shown in this case. Identify the vascular pathology shown in this case. Identify the vascular pathology shown in this lesion. Come on. B. Some people are saying Safina Varix. Very good. You all are right. Yes. Try to understand. This is the scrotum. Hence, this is what? This is groin. And you are actually seeing varicosity at the level of groin. What is this varicosity at the level of groin known as? This is known as Safina Varix. This is what is known as Safina Varix. So actually the answer to this question is Safina Varix. Answer to this question is Safina Varix. You must have heard of caput medusae. This is venous dilatation. Periumbilical venous dilatation is seen in case of what? Portal hypertension. So caput medusae is first of all periumbilical. This is periumbilical. Yes. And this is associated with what? Portal hypertension. So periumbilical and portal hypertension, there are two important things. So dilated superficial periumbilical vein. So dilated superficial periumbilical vein there. If you see, can you see this area? Can you see this? Yes. Here there is what? Yes, distension. So vascular, or you can say a vascular defect at the level of groin. This is what is a classical Safina Varix. Let us talk about some other special terms that we are discussing here. What is a reticular vein? What is ataxia telangiectasia, etc., etc.? Let us see. Okay. Let us talk about telangiectasia. So what are the features of chronic venous insufficiency? What are the features of chronic Venus insufficiency. Insufficiency. The first that you talk about is spider veins. Spider veins, these are also known as telangiectasias. Telangiectasias. So spider veins or telangiectasias. Students, what is the criteria for spider veins or telangiectasias? The criteria is less than 1 mm. Yes, less than 1 mm. Less than 1 mm. Intradermal venules. Intradermal venules. So intradermal venules. This is what is. Let us talk about the second phenomena, which is known as reticular veins. Reticular veins. Yes. What is reticular veins? 1 to 3 mm. Yes. Subdermal veins. Subdermal veins. Yes. The next concept that we often get to hear is a varicose vein. What do you mean by a varicose vein? Yes. More than 3 mm. Yes. Superficial. Yes. Vein. More than 3 mm superficial vein. And one very important point is, it should be cosmetically unacceptable. It should be cosmetically unacceptable. Unacceptable. Then what are the other features? Other features of chronic venous insufficiency? Eczema. Yes. Why eczema? Because of the WBCs. Because of the WBCs. Then you get to see ulcers. Ulcers. Then you can get to see pigmentation. Pigmentation. Beta, why pigmentation occurs? Because of what? Hemosiderin deposition. Because of hemosiderin deposition. What else are the features of chronic venous insufficiency? You must have heard of LDS, lipodermatosclerosis. 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 Yes or no? The SIEP classification, which is a very important classification. Last year, lipodermatosclerosis was asked. What is the concept of lipodermatosclerosis? The concept of lipodermatosclerosis is fibrosis at the level of gator zone. Yes or no? Fibrosis at the level of gator zone. Gator's zone. Yes or no? These are classical features. Remember, due to fibrosis, there is narrowing at the level of gator zone, and there will be hypertrophy of calf. Hypertrophy, very good. There will be hypertrophy of calf. And when there is hypertrophy of calf, with the narrowing at the level of what? Yes, narrowing at the level of fibrosis or at the level of gator zone, this appearance is classically referred as what? Champagne bottle leg. Champagne bottle leg. So narrowing at the level of gator zone with a hypertrophy of calf, this is what is known as champagne bottle leg. One more term that is important is dermal flare or corona flebectasia. What do you mean by corona flebectasia? If you see the word, it itself says flebectasia. Corona flebectasia. Fle means vessel, ectasia means dilated vessels. Flebectasia. Bectasia. Let us talk about this. Yes, it is nothing but a small fibrotic patch with radiating reticular veins around it or telangiectatic veins around it. So a small fibrotic patch. Whereas lipodermatosclerosis is a full fibrosis of gator's zone. And this is a dermal flare. So small fibrotic patch with radiating vessel around it. Yes or no? So dermal flare. This is also known as atrophy blanchi. Atrophy blanchi. Atrophy blanchi. Let us move forward, and I have actually a question of SIEP also for you. So let us quickly decide that question. Let us discuss that question of SIEP also. Yes. Can you tell me the answer for this question? What is the SIEP of this lesion? What is the SIEP of this lesion? Why you people are seeing only C4? By seeing pigmentation. But see, but more important is, if you talk about the grading part, if you see, this is what? A non-healing ulcer. This is what is C6. Of course. Here you are having pigmentation. So C4A. Yes or no? Pigmentation. C4A. Yes. So it's a non-healing ulcer. So the highest grade, which is available is what? This is C6. If you see that, this is the zone. Can you tell me what is the biggest risk for this patient? This is not arterial. This is venous. Can you tell me what is the biggest risk for this patient? Yes. Do you know that the margins of this long standing venous ulcer is at risk of something? Can you tell me? Yes. There is a cancer which is known as SCC or Marzolin's ulcer. Yes, is a well defined SCC. Squamous cell cancer arising from two places. Yes or no? Arising from. What are the places from where it is arising? Yes, it is arising from long standing. Yes, venous ulcers. Or second is burn wounds. Yes or no? Let us talk about some important things about this SEEP. Yeah, let us talk about SEEP. Is again a very, very, very important classification that we have to study for exams. Let us talk about SEEP. If you talk about SEEP, what does SEEP stands for? C stands for clinical. What do you mean by clinical? C1 includes your both spider and reticular veins. So clinical appearance, na? Spider veins is there or reticular veins. What is C2? Varicose veins. Yes. What is C3? It is edema. What is C4? C4A is pigmentation. C4B is lipodermatosclerosis. C5 is a healed ulcer. And say 6 is what? Non-healing ulcer. This is very, 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 very important. Then what do you mean by E? E stands for etiopathogenesis. If you talk about etiopathogenesis, it could be EC, that is congenital. EP, that is primary. ES, that is secondary. So EC, EP and ES, etiopathogenesis. Then we have A stands for anatomy. AP, this is a defect in the perforators. Yes or no? Perforators. AS, superficial venous system. And AD is the defect in deep venous system. And then P stands for pathophysiology. Either if it is a problem with what? Perforators, there will be a reflux. Or with a thrombosis, there could be what? Obstruction. Sometimes both. P also. Sometimes R also. Okay, sorry. So P, it could be PR, PO. It could be both. Yes. Let us move to the next set of questions. Let us see that. Okay. Answer this question. 42-year-old chronic smoker presents with a white fibrotic patch over the lateral part of tongue. All except are true. All except are true. Come on, answer me. Associated with disc keratosis, associated with SCC. Speckled variety is the most premalignant of all. And a wide excision or radiotherapy is preferred. Rajabhattar, try to understand the question again. You're partially right. Arre wah. Wah, wah, wah. कहां से आईपीजीएमईआर और नॉर्थ बंगाल. ओके, 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 ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस. दीज आर इजी क्वेश्चंस. ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. बच्चे, व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज अ वाइट फाइब्रोटिक पैच. This is a white fibrotic patch. Yes or no? White fibrotic patch. All except are true. Associated with disc keratosis. Bachche, first of all, tell me the diagnosis. Achha, mere ko diagnosis batao pehle aap log. Then I'll ensure that you answer this. Ye PG ke liye. सर पीजी है, यूजी के लिए नहीं है ये. ओके 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 अंडरस्टैंड. यस, वेरी गुड. दिस इज ल्यूकोप्लेकिया. बच्चे, देर आर 3-4 इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स अबाउट ल्यूकोप्लेकिया विच यू शुड बी नोइंग. ल्यूकोप्लेकिया, व्हाट इज दिस? देर आर 3 टाइप्स ऑफ ल्यूकोप्लेकिया. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ ल्यूकोप्लेकिया, वी हैव नोड्यूलर टाइप. We have nodular type, we have diffuse type, we have diffuse type, we have diffuse type, nodular type, and we have the third is speckled type. Bachi, what is the difference between speckled, nodular and diffuse type? This is like a nodular. A diffuse is spread like this. And what is a speckled type? Multiple patches. बच्चे, अमंग्स ल्यूकोप्लेकिया स्पेकल्ड इज द मोस्ट प्री मैलिग्नेंट अमंग्स ल्यूकोप्लेकिया. सो बच्चे, द पॉइंट दैट यू आर सीइंग, दिस इज एसोसिएटेड, द स्पेकल्ड वैरायटी इज द मोस्ट प्री मैलिग्नेंट ऑफ ऑल एट, मतलब दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली राइट. Okay. No, but see, this is actually you people, na? You people are misguided. There are faculties who have just done this ki ye NEET ke liye nahi hai. This is for FMG, this is for MCH. But see, surgery is the only subject. If you talk about surgery is the only subject where it is NEET is equal to NEXT is equal to FMG is equal to MCH. As far as surgery is concerned, there is no difference in level. You only have to understand the concept. Concept is for everyone. Is that clear? So first thing is that this is a leukoplakia. And amongst leukoplakia, the speckled variety is the most premalignant of all. And you know, this is a precursor for SCC. So this point is also absolutely right. But see, this is not associated with disc keratosis, because disc keratosis is a phenomena which is seen in erythroplakia. Erythroplakia. Yes. Erythroplakia. Yeah. So disc keratosis is a phenomena that we see in erythroplakia. In leukoplakia, you get to see what? Yes. Parakeratosis. Parakeratosis. This is a hallmark feature which differentiates leukoplakia from erythroplakia. Try to understand, this is a hallmark feature. Definitely the treatment of choice that we do is a simple wide local excision. Since it is a precursor of squamous cell cancer, they are highly radiosensitive. Is that clear? They're highly radio sensitive. So option D is right. The answer is A. The answer which is incorrect is what? A. A is incorrect. I'll discuss some important points. By discussing this, I wanted to discuss 5-10 important points about leukoplakia. I also miss North Bengal. Yeah, I miss that life, because after crossing North Bengal, I never got that life again. Yes or no? Yes. And it's awesome to see or interact with kids from North Bengal. Okay. So try to understand something about oral cancer. Oral cancer. Tell me. Most common type. Come on. It's a rapid fire. Most common type overall. Come on. Most common type overall. Yes. Answer is SCC. Answer is SCC. Yes or no? Most common site. Yes. In West. Most common site. West. Most common site overall. Come on. Dono ka answer ek hi hai. I'm giving you the hint. Yes. It is tongue. Yes. Lateral two-third of the tongue. Yes. In India. But in India we eat what? Kamla Pasan, Zuba Kesri, Vimal, blah blah blah. Yes or no? So where do we stuff it? You we stuff it in the what? Buccal cavity or no? Yes, gingival buccal complex. Yeah. So buccal cavity is the answer. Buccal cavity is the answer. Again, prognosis wise, which variety is associated with best prognosis? Come on, tell me. Best prognosis. Which variety is associated with best prognosis? Can you tell me which variety is associated with best prognosis? Best prognosis is associated with CA heart palate. Worst prognosis. Yes. Do you know who is Mukesh Harare? Mukesh Harare. Yes. Mukesh Harare, jante ho na? With every movie that you watch, you have to see Mukesh Harare coming. Yes. So buccal cancers. Yes, until and unless asked about Parklands, you will use that 2-3-4 formula, ATLS modified. Is that clear? No. Yes. Next is something on pre-malignant lesions also. PML. The most common pre-malignant lesion, it is leukoplakia. The most pre-malignant lesion, the answer is erythroplakia. Yes, erythroplakia. Pre-malignant lesion associated with bone-like tongue, ankyloglossia. Yes, or trismus. Which variety is associated with this? Can you tell me? Bache, this is seen with chronic submucosal fibrosis. This is seen with chronic submucosal fibrosis. Submucosal fibrosis. Is that clear to everyone? Yes. Bache, staging of oral cancer is also very, 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 very important. I'll not go into the staging part. Just quickly, I'll brush up to investigation of choice. For diagnosis, answer is biopsy. For staging, what is the answer? Come on. It is a PET CT scan. It's a PET CT. If you talk about staging, nowadays we follow what? TNM, and that is AJCC 8th version. If you talk about AJCC 8th, depth of invasion is what? The newly added. The T1 is defined as less than equal to 2 cm or DOI less than equal to 5 mm. T2 is more than 2 up to 4 cm or depth of invasion more than 5. Yes, Jai Hind Beta, Jai Hind. More than 5 up to 10 mm. Yes, 10 mm. T3 is any lesion more than 4. Beta, AJCC 7 was 4 to 6. But now the 6 window has been removed. Or any patient with any size with depth more than 1 cm or 10 mm. T4 into local invasion, into local structure. So local invasion. Again, students, the N part is also very important. So N1 is solitary lymph node less than equal to 3 centimeters. N2 is defined as solitary lymph node more than 3 but less than 6 centimeters, or multiple lymph nodes, multiple, this is N2A, this is N2B, multiple lymph nodes but none of them should be more than 6 centimeters. N2C, most frequently asked, N2C, yes, bilateral lymph nodes, but none of them should be more than 6 centimeters. Yes, none of them should be more than 6 centimeters. What is N3? Any lymph node, yes or no? Any lymph node with size more than 6 centimeters. Any lymph node with size more than 6 centimeters. Or even if it is, or less than 6 centimeter with extra nodal invasion, with extra nodal invasion. Next is, very quickly we will summarize the treatment part. If you talk about the treatment, we have two things to revise: the treatment of PML, pre-malignant lesion, and treatment of malignancy, cancer. If you talk about treatment of pre-malignant lesion, answer is either you go for wide local excision with 0.5 centimeter margin, or you can also go for radiotherapy, straightforward. Cancer, if you talk about, you go for wide local excision with 1 centimeter margin. Along with this, we have SOHND, supraomohyoid neck dissection, where you are going to remove level 1, 2 and 3. Along with that, plus minus radiotherapy and plus minus chemotherapy. Not all require radio and chemotherapy. Students, 2-3 questions have been asked on this radiotherapy. For whom are you indicating them? Yes, T3 and above. Yes or no? T3 and above. If the lymph nodes are positive, if the tumor free margin, I'll tell you, less than 1 centimeter. Yes or no? Or it is a case of relapse. If depth of invasion, irrespective of the staging, is more than equal to 4 mm. Now, chemotherapy, if you talk about in oral cancers, chemotherapy have limited role and they are only indicated for advanced cancer. Yes. And cisplatin and 5-fluorouracil are the two classical agents that we are going to use. Radiotherapy, if you talk about, 60 grays over 6 weeks. Divided weekly doses you give. Meds education, is it clear? Chemotherapy, take home message, is not required for everyone. It is only for advanced cancers. Let us quickly go to one more question and let us wrap up this session. Okay. Yeah, this is just not this one also. Okay, let us see this thing. Oh, where it is, yeah. Can you see something in this? This is of one of my patient actually. Oh, this way. I'll just enlarge this image also for you. If you want to see this image, na, I can enlarge this image also for you. I'm asking you the grade of injury. First of all, can you tell me what it is? Acha, but dekho, this fellow is really honest. This fellow is dead. बेटा तुम्हारा नाम क्या है? ये तो नाम नहीं होगा, मेट्स एजुकेशन. इंडिया में तो ऐसा नाम नहीं चलता है. नाम बताओ बेटा, आराम से बताते हैं. I'll explain each and everything to you. Yes, try to understand this thing. Gallbladder. This is a post-cholecystectomy. Let me tell you something about this image first. Then. This is a post-cholecystectomy, yes, post cholecystectomy image. This is MRI, and this is I wanted to see the leak. I wanted to see the leak. Yes, try to understand. I wanted to see that there was a query of leak, so it was done. Now try to see the image. But check, can you see one important thing? What is this structure? Now I will help you trace the things. This is what is CBD. Can you trace CBD now? Can you trace CBD? Okay. But say, can you see one clip here? Can you see a foreign body like thing here? Again, try to visualize it. Can you people see? Yes. This is a clip here. Yes. So this is a cystic stump. Abhi dekha? Dekha clip. Can you people visualize the clip? So bachche, this is cystic stump. And cystic stump is absolutely okay. This is the cystic stump and CBD. Yes or no? Abhi dekhte jao. Now, this is the left duct. This is the left duct. And this is the right duct. This is the right duct. Fir dekh rahe. Left or right dikh rahe? Can you see the left duct and the right duct? Are you able to see this? Okay, again try to see. But see, we have a very raw way of seeing the radiology. I never see radiologist report before. If I am highly confused, I will talk to radiologist. Because most of the time radiologists are not available. And we have to see the plate and do the needful. So we have a very raw and crude way of seeing a film. So this is the left duct. Yes or no? Okay. This is the left duct. Left medial, left lateral. This is left medial, left lateral. Can you see left medial and left lateral? But see, this right. Can you see this right now? Can you see this right duct? Yes, you can see this right. And what about this? Right posterolateral. This is a right posterior duct. This is a right posterior duct. And now right posterior duct, there is a contrast coming out of this. There is a contrast coming out of this right posterior duct. Yes or no? So this is right anterior duct and there is a right posterior duct. So actually if you see, this is a case of right posterior duct injury. Actually most frequently injured segmental duct is right posterolateral. And that is why the first step that we do in laparoscopic cholecystectomy is dissection of the posterior window first. There are morons who start dissecting the calots first. No, first separate the liver away from the gallbladder or separate gallbladder away from the liver so that you damage anything but not the hepatic structures. So right posterolateral duct injury, right posterolateral duct injury. Are you able to see this or no? I'll not move forward until unless you confirm me this. Try to see this. Abhi dikh raha hai ki nahi? Right duct ki injury hai. Sabko dikh raha hai right duct injury. Yes, right posterolateral or right posterior duct injury if you are able to. So this is a case of segmental duct injury. This is a case of segmental duct injury. And hence, this is a segmental duct. Either it could be B, either it could be C. A segmental duct injury with a leak is a type C Strasbourg. It's a Strasbourg type C. It's a Strasbourg type C. Strasbourg type C. So now you have the answer to your question. Yes or no? What it is? It's a Strasbourg type C. Type C. Are you getting this or no? Yes. So let us quickly revise this part. Yes. The grades of biliary injury. Did you get it or no? Yes. So again, if you want to see, let us quickly revise the biliary injury. So the grades of biliary injury. नहीं समझ में सुप्रिय बेटा नहीं समझ में फिर से देखना सुप्रिया यस कैन यू सी दिस इमेज अभी यू विल टेल मी ट्राई टू ट्रेस दिस इज अ सीबीडी दिस इज द लेफ्ट डक्ट लेफ्ट हिपैटिक डक्ट and this is the right hepatic duct. Right hepatic duct. This is right anterior duct, and this is where the right posterior duct. This is the right posterior duct. Right posterior duct. If you see, the contrast is leaking out from this. What is this? This is a drain which is placed. How you identify drains? Because it has eyes. This is a drain. And can you see the leak of contrast? The leak of contrast. Abhi samajh mein aaya Supriya beta? Leak of contrast from the right posterior duct. Right posterior duct. And this is what is going to confirm. This is what is going to confirm a segmental duct injury with leak. Is it clear, beta? Yes, yes, yes. Chalo, let us move forward now. Let us move forward. So now you can easily see. So let us quickly revise this Strasbourg injury. Let us quickly revise this Strasbourg and Bismuth. Yes, classification of biliary injury. According to this, type A is minor duct injury, or you can say cystic stump leak. Is that clear? Cystic stump leak. What is a cystic stump leak and what is the concept of minor injury? Bache, do you know there are sometimes there are ducts which drain directly into the what? Which drain directly into the bile duct, into the liver. You must have heard of ducts of Lushka. Have you heard of these ducts of Lushka? So when you remove the gallbladder, yes, when you remove the gallbladder, I'll tell you. When you remove the gallbladder, what will happen? These ducts of Lushka will start leaking out. This is what is the concept of minor duct injury. Or suppose this is a cystic stump where you have put the clips. If this starts to leak, this is what is. Bache, I did this case 2 years back when patient was actually having a xanthogranulomatous cholecystitis. I thought it's a CAGB. I had to convert it into open, and I did an open cholecystectomy, and it was a frozen calots. So what happens post operative? I put a drain, and on day 3 there was 300 cc of bile. So I went for MRCP, and there I saw this profile. However, this patient was managed conservatively, and within 2 days the drain vanished, the drain contents vanished. Until day, the patient is absolutely right. Patient is absolutely fine. So this happens. Now, next is segment B. Maybe it may be a case of low-lying posterior duct, and I might have taken a bite or suture, and that is why there is some. B. B is a segmental duct injury. Segmental duct injury. Sometimes what happens, you take a bite on segmental duct, or you put a clip on segmental duct. Suppose if it is a low-lying posterior, if it is a low-lying posterolateral duct, you have clipped it and cut it also. So you have clipped it and cut it, and now you think that yes, it was a bile duct, thinking it to be a what? A bile, a cystic duct. So segmental duct injury with obstruction. This is what is type B. Segmental duct injury with leakage. Segmental duct injury with leak. What is this known as? Type C. So this is a type C. Segmental duct means right segmental, left segmental. D is a lateral wall, bile duct injury. Bile duct injury. What do you mean by lateral wall bile duct injury? Students, this is the bile duct and which has been injured. So lateral wall bile duct injury. This is what is known as type D. And what is E, students? E refers to what? Strictures. E refers to strictures. You have E1, which is a stricture which is more than 2 centimeters away from the hilum. So this is hilum. If this is hilum, the stricture is more than 2 centimeters away from the hilum. What is E2? The stricture is less than 2 centimeters from hilum. Less than 2 centimeters. What is E3? E3 is defined as a stricture at the level of what? At the level of hilum. This is stricture at the hilum. Yes or no? What is E4? The segmental duct strictures. Yes or no? It's a right hepatic duct injury, a stricture, left hepatic duct. But remember, hilum is spared. The hilum is spared. So segmental duct strictures with sparing of hilum. This is segmental duct strictures. Now what is E5? E5 is segmental duct strictures with hilum also involved. Yes or no? So how to differentiate between 4 and 5? If you see, this is 4. If you see, this is 4. So you will always, if you see this to be the biliary arrangement, you will itself get a 5 written on this. Can you see, if you use your surgical sense, you can guess a 5, a V-shaped stricture. This is what is known as a V-shaped stricture. This is what is known as E5. So is this part clear to you or no? With this, I wind up this session. I will not take a lot of time, and I hope you also enjoyed this. It was worthy. Yes, you got a chance to revise the things with some images. Yes or no? So I will be discussing many such things before exams. Many such classes will be held. So do join me on an academy. Yes, you can get to see all my surgical videos, all my class videos on this. There we conduct free sessions also. We have free sessions. The only thing that you have to do is you have to just download the Unacademy app, and wherever prompted, you use the code Surgery Life. You can use the code Surgery Life. Yes, to have intimation of my classes, you can join me on my Telegram group also, Surgery Dada. Surgery Dada is my Telegram group. You can join this group, and I keep on updating about the classes, when and where I'm going to. If you have any query, you can ask me. Else, I'm just going to wind up this session. Okay, great. Oh, Meds Education, you're from Ohio. Great. Oh, you name. Okay. Mets, where are you from? Chal. Till then, so I say goodbye to everyone. Yes, we can wind up this session. So you can join me on this group, and I keep on updating many interesting things. Yeah, Raipur. So Ohio, sometimes kai bol rahe Ohio, kai bol rahe Raipur. Till anyway.